for CAA soccer here at Stuart and Suzanne Grant Stadium. Steve Donchello alongside Mike Hutz for a great matchup between the UNCW Seahawks and the home team of the University of Delaware Blue Hens. Mike Hutz, what is up with today?
Well, it's definitely going to be a big game. Two of the better teams in the CAA facing off here. Possibly some pretty heavy implications for the postseason and where we're going to end up, whether it's going to tournament's going to be played right here in Delaware, or if possibly it'll be down at UNCW, but see what happens today.
Absolutely. And who are UNCW really bringing to get this W today?
All right. Well, the starting lineup is going to be Sean Melvin in goal. It's going to be Michael Meekum, Matt Morgan, and Huntley Munn on defense. We got Joel Bylander, Jose Garcia, Ben Fisher, and Jordan Cordero in the midfield, and up front, Nathaniel Goodwin and Colin Bonner, who's just been having a stunning season right now. 7 goals so far. Really making a name for himself out there.
Absolutely. And the Hens starting lineup is actually brought to you by the Alfred Lerner College of Business and Economics. And here's the lineup. We're going to have Thomas DiViardi, Philippe Gillen, Dupree, Frost, Delgado, Perales, Talbot, Schroeder, and in goal, number 0, the redshirt freshman, Todd Morton. Great lineup we're going to have here to you today. This is a big game. Hutz, what is going on? What win or loss, what's happening here?
All right. Well, these two teams, like I said, both on the higher end of the standings in the CAA, but possibly this game, the outcome, if Delaware wins, they take the 3rd spot from UNCW, overtaking them in points, possibly giving them the leg up going into the last stretch of the season with only two more games after this.
Absolutely. This is the later half of the season. So this game really does mean a lot for both teams going into the tournament, CAA tournament. And right now we actually have time for the Chevrolet Keys to the Game. Hutz, what are your keys to the game?
All right. Well, the keys to the game today brought to you by Chevy is you just definitely stay organized defensively, especially deal with Colin Bonner. Always a threat at goal. Must be patient in the attack and the transition effectively, offense to defense and vice versa. And if they follow these, then I think it definitely will raise their chances to win.
And those are the Chevrolet Keys to the Game brought to you by your local Chevy dealer. Visit ChevyDealer.com to find a dealer near you. And once again, this Hens All Access broadcast is being brought to you by St. Francis Healthcare. When we come back, we will have the start of this great CAA matchup here at Stuart and Suzanne Grant Stadium. We'll be right back.
Stay connected with the Blue Hens on all social media outlets. Follow at UD Blue Hens on Twitter for score updates, news, and everything Delaware sports. Check out at Hens All Access to see what it takes behind the scenes to bring you Delaware athletics. Interact with the University of Delaware Fightin' Blue Hens on Facebook to get to know the athletes and hear about events offered to Blue Hens fans. And take a look at UD Blue Hens on Instagram for game times, game finals, along with throwbacks of old Hens and promos for future Hens.
I'm on a hill, King Kendrick, resurrecting my vengeance. Been dissecting your motor mouth till I break down the engine. This ain't a wanna shot, this a relevant henchman. See my opponent, then cease your existence. See, it's gonna take a whole lot of y'all to kill me. I never die, my pedigree apparently only to idolize. Ahead of me, it's only my future and not on time. Longevity, I gotta get used to making you mine. You telling me I only get used to living is fine. You can never live in my shoes, probably leaping from God.
When the sun goes down, I scream loud, sleep when I die.
Company, so I need to collect your phone so you can't post pictures. Okay, how does it feel to not be connected?
My chest hurts.
Well, let me give your phones back. Let me show you a better way to keep connected. The 2016 Chevy Cruze offers built-in 4G LTE Wi-Fi that connects up to 7 devices.
So this thing puts out its own signal?
Yes.
This is next level, Chevy.
Globetrotters!
This is where you won't believe becomes you'll never forget.
Returning to the Bob Carpenter Center March 8th at 7. For tickets, log on to Ticketmaster.com.
Stay connected with the Blue Hens on all social media outlets. Follow at UD Blue Hens on Twitter for score updates, news, and everything Delaware sports. Check out at Hens All Access to see what it takes behind the scenes to bring you Delaware athletics. Interact with the University of Delaware Fightin' Blue Hens on Facebook to get to know the athletes and hear about events offered to Blue Hens fans. And take a look at UD Blue Hens on Instagram for game times, game finals, along with throwbacks of old Hens and promos for future Hens.
I tell them on a hill, King Kendrick.
Kendrick, resurrecting my vengeance. Been dissecting your motor mouth till I break down the engine. This ain't a wanna shot, this a relevant henchman. See my opponent, then cease your existence. See, it's gonna take a whole lot of y'all to kill me. I never die, my pedigree apparently only to idolize. Ahead of me, it's only my future and idle time. Longevity, I gotta get used to making you mine. You telling me I only get used to living is fine. You can never live in my shoes, promise leaping from God.
When the sun goes down, I scream loud, sleep when I die.
Company, so I need to collect your phone so you can't post pictures. Okay, how does it feel to not be connected?
My chest hurts.
Well, let me give your phones back. Let me show you a better way to keep connected. The 2016 Chevy Cruze offers built-in 4G LTE Wi-Fi that connects up to 7 devices.
So this thing puts out its own signal?
Yes.
This is next level, Chevy.
Globetrotters!
This is where you won't believe becomes you'll never forget.
Returning to the Bob Carpenter Center March 8th at 7. For tickets, log on to Ticketmaster.com.
Stay connected with the Blue Hens on all social media outlets. Follow at UD Blue Hens on Twitter for score updates, news, and everything Delaware sports. Check out at Hens All Access to see what it takes behind the scenes to bring you Delaware athletics. Interact with the University of Delaware Fightin' Blue Hens on Facebook to get to know the athletes and hear about events offered to Blue Hens fans. And take a look at UD Blue Hens on Instagram for game times, game finals, along with throwbacks of old Hens and promos for future Hens.
I'm on a hill, King Kendrick, resurrecting my vengeance. Been dissecting your motor mouth till I break down the engine. This ain't a wanna shot, this a relevant henchman. See my opponent, then cease your existence. See, it's gonna take a whole lot of y'all to kill me. I never die, my pedigree apparently only to idolize. Ahead of me, it's only my future and idle time. Longevity, I gotta get used to making you mine. You telling me I only get used to living is fine. You can never live in my shoes, promise leaping from God.
When the sun goes down, I scream loud, sleep when I die.
Company, so I need to collect your phone so you can't post pictures. Okay, how does it feel to not be connected?
My chest hurts.
Well, let me give your phones back. Let me show you a better way to keep connected. The 2016 Chevy Cruze offers built-in 4G LTE Wi-Fi that connects up to 7 devices.
So this thing puts out its own signal?
Yes.
This is next level, Chevy.
Globetrotters!
This is where you won't believe becomes you'll never forget.
Returning to the Bob Carpenter Center March 8th at 7. For tickets, log on to Ticketmaster.com.
Stay connected with the Blue Hens on all social media outlets. Follow at UD Blue Hens on Twitter for score updates, news, and everything Delaware sports. Check out at Hens All Access to see what it takes behind the scenes to bring you Delaware athletics. Interact with the University of Delaware Fightin' Blue Hens on Facebook to get to know the athletes and hear about events offered to Blue Hens fans. And take a look at UD Blue Hens on Instagram for game times, game finals, along with throwbacks of old Hens and promos for future Hens.
And welcome back to another edition of CAA Soccer here on Hens All Access. Once again, this broadcast is being brought to you by St. Francis Healthcare. As you can see, the anthem just wrapped up, and we will shortly begin CAA Soccer very, very shortly. Huts, this is a big one right now.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
For both teams. Delaware just coming off a huge win against ranked Maryland, 20th in the nation. First time they beat a team ranked that high since 2013 when they beat two teams that were ranked number 3. And then just placement-wise, going into the CMA tournament, this is very large. It has a lot of implications going into it.
Oh, yeah. It's a huge confidence booster, too, coming into coming off a game like this against a big opponent, UNCW. This is big. This is could possibly help determine where they're going to be in the CAA at the end of the season when everything wraps up. And I mean, I can say if I was coming off a game beating number 20 in the nation, I'd say I feel pretty good in the next game.
Absolutely. And going down the stretch of the season, it's great to see the Blue Hens really start scoring. Because in the beginning of the season, it was really hard for them to find the back of the net. And the past couple games, they've been really finding it in a couple different ways from a couple different guys. So really great to see the offense start picking up at such a great time. Very big time. The house here is packed. Not many empty seats here. But it's great to see such a great atmosphere.
I know
and a great
if I
time.
Wasn't here in the box, I'd be down there in the bleachers. I know that for sure.
Absolutely. And we are just about set to start it off. And we are on our way as the ball gets thrown back to the backfield.
Just some defensive play back there, trying to move the ball around, possibly spread the field a bit.
We're looking at a little bit different of an alignment that Delaware's used to. They are usually going for that 4-4-2. Today they have more of a little bit of a diamond setup. Really trying to spread out the field and get these guys moving.
Yeah, I think it's definitely what they're looking to do is possibly pull the UNC field a bit wider than they're used to.
Absolutely.
And probably try to create those gaps in the midfield to get it up to either Guillermo or Joe.
As they move it across.
And it's going to be a foul going for the Delaware side.
Absolutely.
Again, working that defense.
To Schroeder. Moves it across the field, and it will be cut off by UNCW, and a great save! Blocked on the outside and hit to the far side as we'll go across and out of bounds. It will be UNCW's ball. It will be a throw in, but an absolutely amazing save on that far side on the far post.
Yeah, that was a
by
good
Todd Morton.
That was a good steal by UNCW to set up the attack there. Really caught Delaware on their back foot.
Absolutely. It was cut off, kind of like a lazy pass, but UNCW was on the offense and got a good shot on goal.
Absolutely.
Corner kick for UNC. Number 10, Jose Garcia, will be taking the kick.
Initially, that looks like it's Ben Fisher.
Yep, they did switch last second. And here's the kick. A short one, toss on the outside, header from 17, and a shot on goal, and it's just wide on the far post, as the shot was from number 4, Joel Bylander. And it will be a goal kick right here. Todd Morton with the kick. Had a great game against Maryland, only holding them to one goal. The very, very gritty Maryland team.
Oh, yes.
Once again, as I said before, number 20th in the nation to only hold those Terps to one goal. Very, very big game for him.
Yeah, and they were really knocking on the door at the end of it. Put real pressure on Delaware. It's just real good look by Daviardi to score that last, the 89th minute.
Absolutely.
This is UNCW's final road game of the season, so they're going to be playing on home turf after this. Delaware looking to possibly put them in a bit of a hole and help their own postseason hopes. That's a good cross.
Good cross. Move it in dangerous territory. Take the shot, and it's up high. But number 10, Jose Garcia. Garcia is very active in there right now.
Oh, yeah. He's been in most of the build-up so far. He's over there at the corner, possibly pulling a Delaware player off by faking the short pass in.
Absolutely. A lot of these passes being really cut off by this UNCW team. Delaware really does need to make sure that they're pinpointing because this team can capitalize. They are ranked number tied for 3 in the nation, in the CA, I should say, for a reason. Kick across, as you can see.
And UNCW.
Gatto trying to get to it, and will be a throw in Delaware ball. Frost is going to be throwing in the ball for the Blue Hens. Frost with the ball. As they kick it upfield. Race for the ball. Looking to cross. He hangs onto it. Moves up as he crossed. It was blocked by a Blue Hen, and it's moving upfield. And it's going to be Seahawks throw in here.
Delaware offense really looking to bring something in here. They've first time in since 2014, they have two back-to-back three-goal games. So their offense really on fire recently, but so far they really need to put a bit more pressure upfield.
Absolutely. As you can see, right now not too much action going on the offensive side for the Blue Hens. Most of the time just been on the defensive side. Munn passes it to Meekum. Meekum hangs on to it, looking for an open man. Blue Hens get the ball back. It will stay with the Blue Hens. Back to Samson. Crosses it. Off of Seahawk, back to the Blue Hens as they're making a run down the sideline on the near side. Schroeder with the ball, crosses it in, and it's headed out. Seahawks trying to get down the field. Crosses it to the far side. And moves it upfield, and it's going to be straight to the goalkeeper. Todd Morton rolls it out. Schroeder. Blue Hens really trying to find holes in the defense as they pass it upfield. And we'll go to the goalkeeper, Sean Melvin. Melvin passes it to Meekum. Meekum to Goodwin. Goodwin to Bylander. Cordero with the throw in. As it will be deflected by the Blue Hens as they look to take it upfield. Cordero with the ball. Passes it off, and it will be a Seahawks throw-in. Bylander with the ball. To Munn. And another Seahawks throw him.
They seem to really have a very powerful presence right now in the Delaware half. Delaware defense finding it difficult to try to keep them out.
Absolutely, and it will be Seahawks ball.
It's a free kick in a potentially dangerous spot if someone can get a good head on that one.
Absolutely, we'll see how good the crack is to get it in. We have Jose Garcia taking a kick as he lines it up, pops it in, and he will be headed out by the Blue Hens on the near side. As you can see, Fisher really tried to get that ball. Fisher with the throw-in to Munn. Bylander cut that one off and is passing it outside to the far side corner. Moving inside. He will cut in, try to make a shot, crosses it in, and it will be kicked out by the Blue Hens. Once again, another Seahawks throw in by Cordero.
That was some really good focus on the defense there. You could have saw there's a Seahawks player just behind him. If he let that pass get through, that might have potentially been a goal.
And on the far side, you can see Ian Hennessy really trying to push his players to get the ball on the other side of the field.
Oh, yeah. They've been playing most of this game on the Delaware side. I think they really need to focus on Guillermo Delgado. He's 6 goals on the season. He could potentially be the one to open this game wide open if they can get it down there.
Absolutely. Throwing from Cordero. Cordero throws it in. Up in the air, in the box, kicked out by the Blue Hens. Delgado loses that one. And it's kicked upfield, headed for number 11, Ben Fisher, but an offsides is called.
So this could be an interesting one. Delaware is 4-9 all time against UNCW, so they've lost 9 of them. Only won 4 potentially. I'm sure they're hoping they can make it 5 now.
Yeah, absolutely. And we are at the later stretch of the season. The Blue Hens only have 2 more games. They're both conference games, so the next will be playing James Madison at home 7 p.m. and then William & Mary at William & Mary. And then for the UNC Seahawks, they will be playing 2 more games, 1 in-conference game against the College of Charleston, and then Fuller Gulf Coast, both at home. So,
and then after that, on to the tournament, November 7th to 15th. CAA postseason games will be played at various campuses, as we talked about, with the outcome of this game possibly deciding where one of those locations is going to be.
Absolutely. And right now we see Blue Hen ball. There we get the kick. Ben Sampson with the kick. Sophomore out of Medford, New Jersey. Sampson passes it back to the goalkeeper, Mortensen. Morton. Morton to the outside. And a kick upfield. Headed for Delgado, a race to the corner, as it will be now a Blue Hen throw-in. Great pressure by the Seahawks right now. Really not giving any of the Blue Hens any chance at really making any advance up towards the goal.
There's some good ball movement.
Kicked up.
Just kept inside.
Number 7, Carlos Perales, trying to kick it in, and he takes a shot, and it's headed out. It will stay in, Seahawks, and it will be a corner kick. A lot of contact inside.
Yeah, with a game with this many implications, it's not surprising that it's definitely going to be a physical one. Get some pushing, shoving, any kind of upper hand you can get in there, especially close up to the goal. And the corner's up.
And it's headed out. Moving it up. And the shot, and it's headed in! It's a goal for the Blue Hens. Number 21, Thibaut Philippe, sophomore out of France. Absolutely amazing header.
That was a great cross.
Beautiful
really,
cross.
Really caught in the end. You could see it just went just in between the arms of the goalkeeper.
Absolutely great.
Sean Melvin, he had his arms up. He looked like he was ready for it, but just sneaked by him. Great goal. Really good to start this game off. Really going to help give the Hens an upper hand against this tough UNCW
Absolutely.
Team.
This is a great time to score. Really, they really wanted to set the tone, is what Coach Hennessy really talked about, especially moving into the really conference play. So great way to start off the game, especially with the ball being on the other portion of the field.
Oh, yeah, that's a big statement they just made, that you can keep the ball on Delaware's side of the field for half the game, but as soon as we get it to the other side, we're going to attack that net. Great goal. 14, Joe Dupree. Joe Dupree giving the assist. He actually just moved up to be the fifth in program history, tied with two others for amount of assists. That is a total of 13 career assists, and he just added a 14th one to that one. So big work for him so far.
Absolutely. We have a Blue Hen down. He's back up. Trainer's going out to look at him.
Ref's looking to start up this game again.
So what have you seen so far in the Blue Hens that really did translate to their keys of the game, brought to you by Chevy?
I'd say the transitioning. They've been on the defensive side for most of the game, and you saw when they just got up there in upfield, they just worked the ball around, and that's definitely key to that transitioning from defense to offense that we talked about. Really, really keying into what you're supposed to do and changing your pace that quickly, it's really going to show, it's really going to help them later on in the game when things start getting to the later half, and depending on what the score is, it might be another close game like with Maryland.
Absolutely.
Also, defense doing a very good job keeping the attack down. Getting in a few UNCW, the Seahawks getting in a few times, but cut out every time. Headed away, blocked passes, everything just stifling the attack. There's another show of the physical game. Got a few little pushes in there.
Absolutely. With this intensity and this late in the season, you'll see these guys really fight for anything at this point.
You're looking to claw every inch you can up that standings.
Mm-hmm.
Try to be as high as you can at the end.
Seahawks on the attack. Crossing it to the near side. Crossing it in. And a great save by the Blue Hen keeper, Todd Morton. Redshirt freshman from Westchester, PA. And he will clear it out across midfield. And it will go to the other side of the field to Sean Melvin, the junior goalkeeper. Garcia. To Cordero. Cut off by the Blue Hens. And it will be a Seahawk throw-in. Morgan. To Cordero. Cut off by the Blue Hens, and it's a race upfield. And it's cut off by the Seahawks.
Yeah, that looked like that pass just kind of took a...
Meekin taking it upfield to Fisher. Fisher fighting on the outside, cuts it in. Pass to number 10, Garcia. Garcia blocked by the Blue Hens. Cordero back to the goalkeeper, Melvin. Melvin to Meekum. Meekum to Morgan. Seahawks moving it up. Bonner with the ball. This is the guy that Delaware really wants to shut down this afternoon, and they will cross it in. And it is all Todd Morton's ball. Schroeder upfield, looking for Delgado. Delgado coming on the outside, and we Seahawk ball. Delgado trying to get to that ball. Can't get to it. Schroeder with the header. Schroeder to Perales. Perales moving upfield. Being stopped by Bylander. Seahawks will not get the throw in. Schroeder with the throw in. Pass outside to Perales. Perales moves it in to Schroeder. Back to Perales.
Good recovery there in the build-up.
To the outside. Move it back in. Cut it across field. Back to Schroeder. To Sampson.
You could really see that precision is going to be a big part of this game because they had that attack building up, and that one slightly off pass really kind of just set them back a bit. So it's going to be a tough game they're going to play. Everything needs to be on point, and I mean they're up 1-0 right now, so it's looking good for them so far.
And don't forget to follow Hens All Access on Twitter to see all the behind-the-scenes work that we do here at Hens All Access. So once again, it is at Hens All Access, and you'll see all the behind-the-scenes work that we do here with the crew. And it will go to the Seahawks.
Ref giving him a little bit of a warning there, making sure he's not going to do that again.
And senior Jose Garcia will be taking the kick. Garcia lines it up. And great save by Todd Morton, the redshirt freshman.
Had to stretch up a little bit for that one.
Kicks it across midfield, headed back by the Seahawks. Blue Hens lose the ball. As number 13, Calvin Cromer will get the ball and cross it. So Ben Fisher with the shot. And Morton with another grab.
Morton having a great season so far. He's averaging only letting in 0.712 goals per game, so that's less than one a game. Really, really doing well. He's got a 0.829 in the past seven games. That's his save percentage, and that's a really good one. He's really stepping up near the end of the season in the stretch.
Absolutely, and for a young guy, it's great to see some leadership out of him.
Oh yeah.
Coming down the stretch.
It's definitely going to help having us having a lot of seniors on the team right now. Some of the bigger names. It's going to be good to have a younger guy coming up there filling that place.
Bonner with the ball. And we'll stay with the Seahawks.
No card shown. Looks like it's just going to be a foul.
And it looks like once again, Jose Garcia will be taking the kick. At a College Park, Georgia. And he's ready. The kick. Headed out by the Blue Hens. back in the possession of the Seahawks. Munn with the ball. Looking to take a shot. Offsides is called by the line ref.
You know, going into this game, it really is a tale of two teams. Both teams, great records, but UNCW losing two of its past three games. Looking to be slowing down right now at the end of the season, whereas Delaware has won their past three games, beating Drexel 5-1, Northeastern 3-2, and Maryland 2-1. They're really scoring. They're really putting their name up on the board. I guess this is kind of when a team that's getting hot at the end of the season meets a team that might be slowing it down a bit and see what happens.
It almost feels like it's too perfect for the Blue Hens right now.
Oh, yeah.
For this game to come up with the Seahawks.
I'm certainly not complaining, though.
Absolutely. And the other Blue Hens American football team won on the field right behind us. Big win for the football team.
Oh, yeah. Beating UNH. Really, really trying to right the ship right now.
Absolutely.
I'd say that's a good step towards it.
Great running attack yesterday by the two running backs.
Come on, ref. It's not about you. Let him play.
As we will get a substitution.
Back in the game for the Blue Hens, number 12, Soren Frost.
And Frost will be coming into the game as the ball will be kicked across midfield and headed. Bonner fighting for the ball. Kicks it back to number 11, Ben Fisher. Ben Fisher moving upfield will cross it into the box and it'll move right along to the back far corner.
That was a really nice back heel to try to get that in there up to Bonner, but just couldn't find through on the cross to get across field. Good defense covering the people running up to meet on the other end of the pass, though.
Absolutely. So. No look back heel pass. You can't get better than that.
No. It's always a beautiful thing to see.
Absolutely. And Todd Morton will take the kick. As it will move across, just short of midfield. Fisher will lose the ball. Go back in Blue Hens possession. Morton with the kick. Morgan to Munn. Munn loses it, and it will be now Blue Hens ball and Blue Hens throw in. Schroeder. Had the throw in. And back to Schroeder. To Sampson. Across the field. To the far side. To Schroeder. And it looks like the Blue Hens will get the ball back on that trip.
Like we've been saying, physical game.
Absolutely. Did not look intentional, but a trip is what it was. Schroeder. Move it to about midfield. Cut off by the Seahawks, back in Blue Hens possession to Schroeder. To the box, headed in. Will it stay in? The goalkeeper for the Seahawks will get it, and that will be Sean Melvin, the junior goalkeeper from Victoria, British Columbia. Garcia to Cordero, and back to Morgan. Morgan back to Cordero. Cordero. It's a good one. Goodwin loses it. Back in Blue Hens. Possession. Kicks it up into the box. Morgan will pass it out. And it will be a corner kick for the Blue Hens. Great scoring opportunity. As you can see, they did capitalize on their last corner kick opportunity with the header. The corner will be crossed in and we'll just
sneak past everyone in there.
Yeah.
A single touch just kind of bounced right through.
Melvin with the kick. Right along midfield, headed by Bonner. Back to the goalkeeper, Morton. Morton looking for an open man. Being pressed by number 11, Ben Fisher, and then he will kick it to about midfield. Blue Hens with the ball. Moving it upfield, making a dash down. Moving along into the box, across in, and no one is there. And the Seahawks are on the attack as they are moving upfield. Bonner. And the offsides call is made. Blue Hens moving it up. Dug out with the shot, and it is saved by Sean Melvin, number one.
Delaware was really showing that transition. They seem to be doing more of a – they had that one big buildup, but they're really doing having a bursty attack where just everybody rushes up there, just quick, get it in, see what you can do on the goal, and then it usually ends up back on their side. So.
Yeah, not too heavy on possession.
No, that's really –
the majority of the time has been with the Seahawks.
That's really not something it seems like they're focusing on today, but – so it's working out for them so far.
Bonner passes it up. No Seahawks in the territory. Looks like Todd Morton will be getting the ball and passing it out to Philippe. Philippe passes it up. Seahawks get the ball. Bonner with the ball moves it up. Looking upfield into the box and the cross. There isn't a Seahawk there. And the shot, and it is saved by Todd Morton. Great kick save by Morton. Quick shot by Ben Fisher on that cross.
That was a really – it was a good run right across the field, but Morton just able to get his hand on it, push that thing out of bounds.
Quick instincts to kick out that leg.
Good defensive effort, too. They were running with him step for step all the way across.
Morton with the kick. Blue Hens with the ball. Cut off by Cordero. Goodwin with the ball. Goodwin loses it. Oh, moving along. Looks like he was held. And the Blue Hens will keep the ball. Little frustration shown by him right there. As there was a tug on the jersey, an obvious tug of the jersey.
You can see that in the frustration. It's understandable, but yelling at a ref, never a good idea.
Yeah. And the whole Blue Hen sideline is very frustrated now. As you can see, that could have been a very, very serious attack right there.
In a position to dump that free kick in, see what had happened.
Seahawks with the ball.
Morton just getting above him to grab it. UNCW player trying to appeal to the ref, saying that he was outside of the box, but refs having none of that.
As we have about shortly 13 minutes left in this game, Blue Hens up 1-0 over the UNCW Blue.
In the half?
Yes, my bad. In the half currently. Munn with the ball. Passes it to number 11, Fisher. Fisher looking upfield. Looking to move it in. Passes deflected off of Blue Hen and kicked out by Philippe. Will be a Seahawk throw-in by number 11, Ben Fisher. Fisher sticks with the ball. Fisher. Kicked across field. Kicked out by the Blue Hens. Cleared out. And it looks like it will be Seahawk ball. Huntley Hun with the ball. Garcia with the ball. To Morgan. Oops, looks to slip on the ball.
A little bit of a tussle there at midfield.
Yes. Morgan to Garcia. Garcia kicks it upfield. To the dangerous Bonner. Bonner's moving in on it. Looking for the option, crosses it in, and is cleared by Philippe. Cleared outside to about midfield, headed back Blue Hen territory.
Again, you can see that the defensive focus the Blue Hens have been showing all game, really making sure to get in between the ball, break up passes. Again, that could have been a very, very dangerous short cross, but he just managed to get his head in there and knock it out.
Thrown in, thrown right back at the Seahawk possession as kicked upfield. Goalkeeper Morton will collect that one. Rolled outside. Philippe with the ball. Passes it to the middle of the field. And that will go to Schroeder. Schroeder to Sampson. Back to Schroeder. To Perales. To Sampson. Bonner with the ball, passes it up. Cut off by Thibaut Philippe, and the Blue Hens will move upfield. Cut off by Seahawks Morgan. Blue Hen throw in on the far side. As you see a substitution.
Down game for Blue Hen number 6, Nick DiRienzo.
And we have number 6. Nick DiRienzo coming in the game. A senior midfielder. Out of Hope's Custom, Delaware, and there's a shot, and it goes right over the goalie's head. Kick by Sean Melvin on the way.
Go just short of midfield, headed by the Blue Hens. Being the far side and cleared out by Morgan. Seahawks trying to be in the attack, kicking it forward. Shane Meekham would try to force it up, and as you can see, Todd Morton with the save. Offside is called by the line ref.
Seems like right now both teams are kind of, their offenses are both sort of sputtering, seem to be getting into the attacking half of the field and just kind of falling short before they can even get to the box. Down to about 7 minutes left here before we go to halftime. See if anything might be, if either side maybe might be able to get something done before then.
Shutter with the ball. Looking for an open man. Passes it to Ben Sampson. Sampson. Thibaut Philippe with the ball. Be crossed. To Schroeder.
Good in and out passes going up. On.
And Delgado trying to do something with it. Back to Schroeder. As they're on the attack and they move it in, and the shot is saved by number one, the goalkeeper, Sean Melvin.
Powerful shot, not a lot of movement on it, though. Kind of seemed like it was probably an easy one for Melvin to save there, but nonetheless, had a lot of force behind it.
Moving upfield to Bonner. Bonner trying to press it upfield. Pass to midfield. Blue Hens trying to get all over it. Blue Hens will regain possession as there are two men down, one for both sides.
Yeah, a little bit of a collision there between the two players. Ref going and checking on them.
Trainer's out, not yet. They're not out yet. There we go. The Blue Hens are all back on their feet while there's still one.
Fisher's still down. Trainer going out now.
As we get down to just about 5 minutes left in the half, Blue Hens are up 1-0 over the Seahawks of UNC Wilmington. Pretty good half by the Blue Hens.
Yeah, it's been pretty good play by both teams. Blue Hens coming out on top with their one goal, but defense is looking strong for both teams. Midfield play looking great. Delaware's passing has been phenomenal. They've had some really creative fashions. We saw last there, just in that last run up there, they had a lot of in and outs going on. Weaving in between the UNCW defenders, but looks like Fisher's back on his feet. He's walking off.
Absolutely. Moving forward, what would you say going into halftime Coach Ian Hennessy would talk to the team about?
I'd say probably more of the same. Maybe a bit more consistency in the attacking half, but
now, do you think that the lack of possession on the Blue Hens side is a huge factor to whether really the outcome of this game?
I think late in the game it definitely could be, with possibly players getting tired once the fatigue starts to set in, but this bursty style, it seems like a lot of times they're catching UNCW on their back foot, really pushing forward, and it's working. It's working so far. Late in the game, I don't know if that'll change, but I guess we'll just have to wait and see in the second half.
Absolutely, and there's a substitution. Number 24, Ryan Nally, will come into the game. A sophomore defender from Berlin, Maryland. He has a large family present and friends here. And it will be a Blue Hen throwing. Schroeder with the pass. Toss it in. Head outside. Blue Hen throwing. Last touch by number 24 of the Seahawks, Ryan Nelly. Schroeder to Gillen. Gillen back with the ball. Samson passes it to Thibaut Philippe. And Philippe passes it back to the goalkeeper, Morton. Morton kicks across midfield to Cordero. Very physical game, as you can see. A lot on the line. Moving forward. Moving into the CAA tournament. Moving across into the box. Seahawks trying to regain possession, and it will be a goal kick for number one, the goalkeeper, Sean Melvin.
This is the second to last home game down here at Stuart Suzanne Grant Stadium. They will be playing on October 28th against James Madison here. It's going to be a 7 p.m. game, so it'll be under the lights here. It'll be looks to be a good one. JMU 2-2-2 in the CAA. Not the best record, but looking to possibly pick up a few points before going into the postseason and see if maybe they can get something done there. I think it definitely could be a good one. Maybe help Delaware if they can win that one, gain more points on the teams ahead of them.
Absolutely, and as we said before, this game has a lot riding on it. Moving into CAA tournament. With a win or a loss, it does do a lot to where the teams do play. So with the Delaware win, there is a good percentage that Delaware will be playing the UNCW Seahawks here at home at Stuart and Suzanne Grant Stadium. And with a loss, their chances of playing home really do dwindle down.
Oh, yeah. They might end up on their turf. And see, obviously see what the result of this game is, and that could either help or hurt the team if they meet again.
Absolutely, and you just saw a deflection go over the post, and now it's a goal kick for Melvin.
Approaching about 2 minutes left in this half. See if either team can do something here.
Melvin with the kick. No bounce. To about midfield, where the Blue Hens get possession. Seahawks trying to move it up to Bonner. Bonner moving up. Captain looking for the cross. Gets the cross. And the goalkeeper, Morton, reaches over for the save.
Looks like there's a little bit of a deflection on that cross. Looks like it hit the Delaware player just a little bit, popped it up a bit higher. Gave Morton a little more time to judge where it was and pull it down.
Morton cross midfield. Late attack by the Seahawks here as they move it up. Seahawks just missed that one. It'll be cleared out.
1 minute left in the first half.
And it'll be off of Blue Hens. Under a minute remaining left in the half. Blue Hens up 1-0 over the Seahawks of UNC Wilmington. Blue Hens making a late run right here. Delgado looking to run upfield. Clear it out by the goalkeeper. Across midfield to Schroeder. Blast off the Blue Hens. And it will be Blue Hens' ball as last touched by Munn.
Yeah, you could see him trying to keep it in the line there, but it just eked his way out and gives Delaware possession here at the end of the half. And that should be the end of it right now.
As you can see, Very interesting half as the Hens scored early by an early header by the one and only Thibaut Philippe. Great possession by the Seahawks as the Blue Hens did touch it here and there, but it was mostly held by the Seahawks for the majority of the first half.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And I think that could definitely help them later in the game. I think Coach Ian Hennessy, he really needs to, instill a sort of precision that Delaware, I think, needs to pick up on. They need to be more accurate with their passes, safer chances. But in terms of opportunities and attempts created on a goal and in the attacking half, they're definitely doing a good job with that. It's really kind of been, I think Delaware has the upper hand when it comes to the attacks and possession. As we can see, UNCW held on the ball for quite a bit of the half.
And I'm positive this large crowd here at Stuart and Suzanne Grant Stadium would love to see the Hens put another one in the back of the net because they would love to make some noise here. Very large crowd. And once again, this broadcast brought to you by the one and only St. Francis Healthcare. We are Hens All Access. Steve Nochoa here with Mike Hutz. We'll be right back after halftime.
The beloved annual Youth Cheer Day event at Delaware Stadium is back for another year. Don't wait until the last minute. Event registration is open and filling quickly for the Delaware football home finale on Saturday, November 14th. No cheerleading experience needed. Registration includes a pregame clinic with the Delaware cheerleaders, followed by an on-field halftime performance for all to enjoy. For details and to register, visit bluehens.com.
You can now watch all Hens All Access content on any of your devices. Whether you're at the store on your phone or on the couch with your iPad or laptop, Hens All Access live and on-demand content is just a touch away. Not only will live games be available on your mobile devices, they'll also be available in high definition. Best of all, you don't even need an app. Just click over to bluehens.com on your device and take the Hens anywhere you go.
We bring you the Maryland Terps as they take on their geographical rivals out of the CAA, the Delaware Blue Hens. Now the long ball ahead for Delgado. Controls it. 2-on-3. Now 3-on-3 if they hurry. As getting involved is the right back Schroeder. Instead, Delgado going by himself from a sharp angle all the way toward the end line, accelerating. Flying in is Odoyatsem. The corner to the back post. Headed down and it's in! Smashed in on the back post! Ben Sampson, who had come up from that center back position, a good corner. Close to the goal line, but no real way for the keeper to catch it. And just smashed in. Textbook headed it down, bouncing up into the top portion of the net. It was intended for Elney. Here comes Sebastian Elney from a sharp angle. And last touched by corner. Delaware. It's a corner. Corbeau's high toward the back post. Players there. Headed!
Goal.
And it's a goal! Sebastian Elney on the back post. Smashes in the header. Almost a carbon copy of the goal that put Delaware in front. And we are level with 2 minutes and 9 seconds. Incredible. Oh, it's Korva. Teeing up the cross. There it goes toward the back post. Blocked away. It's not over yet. Devilardi shoots. And it's a goal. A cannon from the top of the box. And
what
after all the work that the Turf put in to finally equalize, it's erased just seconds later with a blast from Thomas Devilardi. Incredible.
What an incredible goal.
Headed away, headed back in by Corvo. Elney flicks it through,
hit.
Williamson is there, and he couldn't get to it. And he smashes it long, there's only 5 seconds. And that's it. What a frustrating evening for the Terps. All of the effort they put in to equalize. Devilardi, of course, a good strike and a good hit, but I think if the Terps had a little more concentration and organization, they would have been able to, at the very least, make it to overtime.
And as Sasha always says, goals are scored after goals. Unfortunate there.
Stay connected with the Blue Hens on all social media outlets. Follow at UD Blue Hens on Twitter for score updates, news, and everything Delaware sports. Check out at Hens All Access to see what it takes behind the scenes to bring you Delaware athletics. Interact with the University of Delaware Fightin' Blue Hens on Facebook to get to know the athletes and hear about events offered to Blue Hens fans. And take a look at UD Blue Hens on Instagram for game times, game finals, along with throwbacks of old Hens and promos for future Hens.
I tell them all the hell, King Kendrick, resurrecting my vengeance. Been dissecting your motor mouth till I break down the engine. This ain't a wanna shot, this a relevant henchman. See my opponent, then cease your existence. See, it's gonna take a whole lot of y'all to kill me. I never die, my pedigree apparently only to idolize. Ahead of me, it's only my future and idle time. Longevity, I gotta get used to making you mine. You telling me I only get used to living is fine. You can never live in my shoes, promise leaping from God.
When the sun goes down, I scream loud, sleep when I die.
Search company, so I need to collect your phone so you can't post pictures. Okay, how does it feel to not be connected?
My chest hurts.
Well, let me give your phones back. Let me show you a better way to keep connected. The 2016 Chevy Cruze offers built-in 4G LTE Wi-Fi that connects up to 7 devices.
So this thing puts out its own signal?
Yes.
This is next level, Chevy.
Globetrotter!
This is where you won't believe becomes you'll never forget.
Returning to the Bob Carpenter Center March 8th at 7. For tickets, log on to Ticketmaster.com.
The beloved annual Youth Cheer Day event at Delaware Stadium is back for another year. Don't wait until the last minute. Event registration is open and filling quickly for the Delaware football home finale on Saturday, November 14th. No cheerleading experience needed. Registration includes a pregame clinic with the Delaware cheerleaders, followed by an on-field halftime performance for all to enjoy. For details and to register, visit bluehens.com.
You can now watch all Hens All Access content on any of your devices. Whether you're at the store on your phone or on the couch with your iPad or laptop, Hens All Access live and on-demand content is just a touch away. Not only will live games be available on your mobile devices, they'll also be available in high definition. Best of all, you don't even need an app. Just click over to bluehens.com on your device and take the Hens anywhere you go.
We bring you the Maryland Terps as they take on their geographical rivals out of the CAA, the Delaware Blue Hens. Now the long ball ahead for Delgado. Controls it. 2-on-3. Now 3-on-3 if they hurry, as getting involved is right back Schroeder. Instead, Delgado going by himself from a sharp angle all the way toward the end line, accelerating. Flying in is Odoyatsem. The corner to the back post. Headed down, and it's in! Smashed in on the back post! Ben Sampson, who had come up from that center back position, a good corner. Close to the goal line, but no real way for the keeper to catch it. And just smashed in. Textbook headed it down, bouncing up into the top portion of the net. It was intended for Elney. Here comes Sebastian Elney from a sharp angle. And last touched by corner. Delaware. It's a corner. Corbeau's high toward the back post. Players there. Headed!
Goal.
And it's a goal! Sebastian Elney on the back post. Smashes in the header. Almost a carbon copy of the goal that put Delaware in front. And we are level with 2 minutes and 9 seconds. Incredible. Oh, it's Korva. Teeing up the cross. There it goes toward the back post. Blocked away. It's not over yet. Devilardi shoots. And it's a goal. A cannon from the top of the box. And
what
after all the work that the Turf put in to finally equalize, it's erased just seconds later with a blast from Thomas Devilardi. Incredible.
What an incredible goal.
Headed away headed back in by Corvo. Elney flicks it through. Hit. Williamson is there, and he couldn't get to it. And he smashes it long. There's only 5 seconds. And that's it. What a frustrating evening for the Terps. All of the effort they put in to equalize. De Villardi, of course, a good strike and a good hit. But I think if the Terps had had a little more concentration and organization, they would have been able to, at the very least, make it to overtime.
And as Sasha always says, goals are scored after goals. Unfortunate there.
Stay connected with the Blue Hens on all social media outlets. Follow at UD Blue Hens on Twitter for score updates, news, and everything Delaware sports. Check out at Hens All Access to see what it takes behind the scenes to bring you Delaware athletics. Interact with the University of Delaware Fightin' Blue Hens on Facebook to get to know the athletes and hear about events offered to Blue Hens fans. And take a look at UD Blue Hens on Instagram for game times, game finals, along with throwbacks of old Hens and promos for future Hens.
I tell them on a hill, King Kendrick, resurrecting my finches. Been dissecting your motor mouth till I break down the engine. This ain't a wanna shot, this a relevant henchman. See my opponent, then cease your existence. See, it's gonna take a whole lot of y'all to kill me. I never die, my pedigree apparently only to idolize. Ahead of me, it's only my future and not on time. Longevity, I gotta get used to making you mine. You telling me I only get used to living is fine. You can never live in my shoes, promise leaping from God. When the sun goes down, I scream loud, sleep when I die.
Search company, so I need to collect your phone so you can't post pictures. Okay, how does it feel to not be connected?
My chest hurts.
Well, let me give your phones back. Let me show you a better way to keep connected. The 2016 Chevy Cruze offers built-in 4G LTE Wi-Fi that connects up to 7 devices.
So this thing puts out its own signal?
Yes.
This
is next level, Chevy.
This is where you won't believe becomes you'll never forget.
Returning to the Bob Carpenter Center March 8th at 7. For tickets, log on to Ticketmaster.com.
Stay connected with the Blue Hens on all social media outlets. Follow at UD Blue Hens on Twitter for score updates, news, and everything Delaware sports. Check out at Hens All Access to see what it takes behind the scenes to bring you Delaware athletics. Interact with the University of Delaware Fightin' Blue Hens on Facebook to get to know the athletes and hear about events offered to Blue Hens fans. And take a look at UD Blue Hens on Instagram for game times, game finals, along with throwbacks of old Hens and promos for future Hens.
I tell them on a hill, King Kendrick, resurrecting my finches, been dissecting your motor mouth till I break down the engine.
And welcome back to the second half of today's contest here at Suzanne Grant Stadium at the University of Delaware. We're going to talk about the keys of the game brought to you by Chevy. Once again, what were the keys of the game, and how was that translated into the first and second half?
All right. Well, the Chevy keys of the game were to stay organized defensively, especially to deal with Bonner. And so far, Delaware's absolutely done that. They've really had the good focus there, really cutting out key players and really just stifling the attack from UNCW. Be patient in the attack. Now, they've rushed their attack more, but so far it's been working out for them. I guess we'll see what happens later on. And transitioning effectively between offense and defense and vice versa. Absolutely. They've done that. They've done that 100%. They can be running up the field at full speed at 1 second, lose the ball, and they're all already back.
So, and out of those three keys, what would you say is the most important key moving into the second half?
I'd say moving into the second half, it's definitely to stay organized defensively. They really need to watch that the attack because, like I said, they've had UNCW's had possession the entire game. It's a matter of time until some players may start to get fatigued, and they just gotta keep that same focus going through the entire game.
Absolutely, and those are the Chevrolet keys of the game brought to you by your local Chevy dealers. Visit ChevyDealer.com to find a dealer near you. Once again, you're tuned into Hens All Access, and this one is being brought to you by St. Francis Healthcare.
Now, I just want to talk about Thomas DeViardi for a second here. He's been having a stellar run in his games. He has at least one assist in the past four games straight, and he's the CAA Player of the Week, also scoring that 89th minute stunning goal over Maryland to shock them and upset. Really, he's just been on fire recently. Maybe see if he can bring a bit of that spark into this game in the second half.
Absolutely. So there's a lot going on campus right here. You're tuned in to watch the men's soccer team play UNCW Seahawks, and then we also have a couple things happening on Hannah Stadium on the baseball field, and then there's also a lacrosse tournament. So a whole lot happening down here on South Campus.
Got a field hockey game being streamed live on the other channel if you want to pop that on too. Maybe have two windows side by side. I know might be a little much to handle, but you know, hey, Delaware sports, why not?
Nothing better than a Sunday afternoon with Hens All Access.
Nothing better.
And we're just about ready to start the second half of today's contest with Bonner with the ball. As you might have heard, over on Rulo Stadium, our field hockey team, the Blue Hens, is leading Old Dominion 2-0.
See what they can do going into the postseason themselves.
Absolutely. They just clinched the postseason berth.
Oh, yeah.
Two nights ago.
Real strong-looking team. They had that big 9-0 win over Towson a few days ago. That was impressive.
Destruction of the Tiger defense. Tonight is senior night at Rulo. As it will be Hens ball.
Looking like he's setting up to take a free kick. Try to pop it in. See if they might be able to work something down at the box.
Chance early here. Here's the kick. Crossed in. The header will be collected by number one, Sean Melvin.
Not the strongest header, but an accurate one.
Looks like he got a header on it on his way down.
Yeah.
Goalkeeper will make it across midfield. Oh. Could have been dangerous. But Morton collects the ball.
Ooh, that kick looked like it took a weird hit off his foot. Just kind of went right straight across the ground there.
Bonner passed it to number 13, Calvin Cromer. Cromer loses it. Cordero with the ball, trying to run it in on the Blue Hen defense. Blue Hens trap that ball.
And here you see again that defensive focus there. You saw a threat on the right side of the field. They had two players close in on that and just kind of stifle it.
Schroeder with the accidental pass. That will go out of bounds. Seahawks throw in. Last off of Bonner. Blue Hens throwing. Large crowd in attendance here.
Oh, yeah.
At Grant Stadium.
I definitely think all these people are probably going to be standing until the very end of this because this looks like it's going to be a great game.
Philippe with the pass up. We'll hit off the chest of the Seahawk.
I believe that looks like Ben Fisher's back on the field. He left, had a bit of an injury right before the half. Good to see him back out there. Really, really having a stellar season. The freshman earning CAA Rookie of the Week. He's got 6 goals on the year. Really playing great. I think he's definitely going to have a good career seeing as he's doing this well in just his first year. So,
and credit a lot of that to the head coach, Ian Hennessy, 10th year here at Delaware. Really knows this program. Delaware moves it up the field. That will go to number 12, Frost. Frost passes it back to Philippe. Sampson. Back to the goalkeeper.
Ooh, that kick had a lot of backspin on it. Really didn't get far.
Nifty footwork there. Jose Garcia with some contact.
Looks like
referee saying no more of that.
Yeah. Looks like he might have just hit his shin a little bit there. I think it's probably just a stinger. Yep, and he's going to walk it off.
It was a very, very physical first half.
That was, and it's definitely going to continue on in this one. As it gets closer to the end of the game, I think it's only going to get more.
The sun is out. It was an overcast day right before the first half. It will remain with the Blue Hens. John Schroeder with the throw-in. Dupree passes it off. Kicking the inside. Goalkeeper Sean Melvin will get that one.
Again, you're really seeing the Delaware. They're the really bursty attack. They get it across the midfield line, and it's just straightforward. No real, not really seeing a need to try to create a pass it around a bit and spread the defense. And so far, they're still managing to get in there.
Cromer to Garcia. Meekum dishes it off. Trying to move up field to the Seahawks. And that will get out of play. And it will be Blue Hen ball. A little bit of confusion with the call.
Looks like that's going to be a UNCW ball instead.
A little confusion as it did look to possibly hit off a Seahawk, but apparently it didn't. Giviardi with the kick. Passes it up as they will move up field. Number 3, Ryan Talbot will move up. Closing in on where the Seahawks, and he's keeping it moving. Trying to get it in the box. Passes it out. Giviardi. To the far side. Diviardi loses it to the Seahawks.
Real good opportunity there passing up field. Just had that slight deflection off the outside foot just to redirect it and give a better pathing. Talbot getting
there.
To it.
Taken away by the Seahawks, moving up field. Number 21. Good one, lost that one. Back in Blue Hens possession. Diviardi with the ball. Takes a shot. We'll rip it, and we'll go far left. Looks to be a little shaken up by that shot.
And he's just going to jog that one off.
Whole lot more offensive pressure. The Blue Hens right now. A lot, I would have to say, at least three times as much than this time in the first half.
Oh yeah, they're still doing the burst attack, but they're keeping a hold of the ball when they're in there. They're not losing it easily. I think it's definitely something Ian Hennessy probably had to say to his team in the halftime, and I think they're definitely heeded what he said and listened to it, because so far it's absolutely showing they're having a much, much better offensive presence.
Delgado with the shot, and we'll go far left again.
Delgado looking ahead to his total 33 goals in his career. Really, he's had a real impressive career here at Delaware. He's always looking to add to that. Actually, that's the looking into that. That's the third most in school history, too shy of second place. Looking to possibly score two more goals before the end of the season and take that spot.
Viardi passes it up to Delgado. Delgado trying to beat the defender. And defender will get a hold of that ball. Delgado wants a call as there was some contact moving up. Delgado gets the ball back. Trying to move up. Trying to make his. And he made his move, and his shot was deflected by the defender, number three, Michael Meekum.
Really did a good job getting in there. Good cut to the outside. Threw off one of the two defenders, but couldn't quite shake Meekum. He was locked in on him and got that deflection.
Great pressure by this offensive front for Delaware. This is not an easy lineup that the Seahawks are throwing at. The Seahawks are ranked currently 23rd for College Soccer News in the national polls right now. So they are up there, and the Blue Hens are putting in a great fight. And here's the cross in. Header is out.
Just a little too high for to reach him. Rolls out a little bit. UNCW is going to hit the throw-in.
Seahawks trying to make an attack. Calvin Cromer with the throw-in. And it's going to leave it for Cordero. And Philippe clears the ball. Morgan with the ball. Pass inside. Blue one's trying to clear it. Garcia with the ball. Passes out to Cordero. Cordero trying to beat his man. Some fancy footwork.
Again, you can see that defensive focus. Hopping all over the place, and Delaware just looked straight at him and said, I'm taking that ball. And that's what he did.
Dupree with the pass. Across the field. Looks to be a little shaken up. Delgado trying to move it up. Crosses it into the box and will be kicked away by number 12, Morgan. Almost taken away by the Seahawks, as it will go back to Joe Dupree on the near side. Looking to cross it. Trying to beat Cordero in. Cordero swipes that one away and will be kicked across midfield. Back in Blue Hen territory.
If the score holds as it is now, it'll be same exact score as last year. Delaware beating UNCW last year on October 4th, 1-0. But that was in overtime. This one would be definitely much more comfortable for the Hens.
Absolutely. And as we said before, the Seahawks are coming off of two losses.
Yes.
And Delaware just came off a huge win at College Park, Maryland, with the 20th ranked Terps down there. So big confidence booster coming to this game. Almost seems too perfect for this game to come up in their lineup.
Oh, yeah. And with 10 goals scored in the last three games, Delaware's offense has really been making itself known. So it's definitely a good run going into the CAA tournament in the upcoming weeks. Definitely a big confidence booster for them, and see what we can do.
And once again, we thank you for joining us here on Hens All Access. This broadcast is brought to you by St. Francis Healthcare. Goalkeeper for the Blue Hens, Todd Morton, will clear that one. And we'll go back to the Seahawks. Ian Hennessy asking for clarification on the sideline.
Yeah, didn't seem too happy with that call.
Cordero. Cordero. To Meekum. Meekum to Matt Morgan. As they look to pressure him. Bonner. And that shot will be blocked. And goalkeeper Morton will get the ball and throw it across the field. Delaware will lose possession. Give it right back to the Seahawks. Jordan Cordero passes it to Jose Garcia. To the far side. Looking to move it up. And it will be a goal kick for Todd Morton. The recap and broadcast archive will be on our YouTube channel, which is at UD Blue Hens. So be sure, if you would like to see this game over again, which is a great game, absolutely go to our YouTube channel at UD Blue Hens.
Seahawks, after this, got two games at home, just recently having an eight-game unbeaten streak at home. So they're definitely a powerful team at home, and they're I think these last two games, depending on what this the result of this game is, these two teams are definitely going to be jockeying with each other in terms of position here. So
Garcia. Passes on the outside.
Just a minor threat from Morton there, picking it up, having one of his defenders and one of UNCW's attackers just kind of running towards him.
Kicked across midfield. Perales trying to make moves, loses the ball. We'll go right back to the Blue Hens.
Just a little bit of hesitation on that kick throw off the UNCW defender.
Gillen passes it back. Morton asking for it. As he will pass it to Philippe. We'll get it to about midfield. Looking to pressure the Seahawks defense. The attack is on for the Blue Hens. Really looking to get a comfortable lead as they scored early in this match.
Yeah, I would not feel safe sitting at 1-0 while you're ahead. It's definitely UNCW has been knocking at the door for the game. They've had a few good chances. Really, I'd say a 2-0 lead would make me comfortable. They definitely need to keep the pressure on attacking. You can't really rest back right now.
Morton looking for the open man. Far past midfield. The last Blue Hen match was a little bit different. All the scoring was done in the later portion of the game. So. Little bit different of a style, really attack style. Especially that Blue Hens didn't have much of possession in the first half at all. And it's very, very good for the Blue Hens to have this possession and know that they are on the attack. And as you can see, attack by Seahawks right here by number 11, Ben Fisher. So he cuts in, makes a cross into the box, and headed by number 23, Colin Bonner. Saved. By the Blue Hen goalkeeper, Todd Morton, a redshirt freshman out of Westchester, Pennsylvania. Bonner with the attack, trying to look it in. Goalkeeper comes out, he makes the save, and it'll be deflected in! By number 21, Goodwin,
And it is all tied up here.
You can see that ball just took a bad deflection off Morton. He wasn't able to pull that in and just teed it up perfectly for Goodwin to come up there and pick the goal up.
Absolutely. Goodwin was right there just waiting for it. And we are all tied up here. Lots of Sea Elks fans here in Newark, Delaware at Stewart and Suzanne Grant Stadium, home of the Blue Hens. As the Blue Hens look to really get back on top, they were very comfortable with that 1-0 lead.
Yeah, they've looked good this half, though. Start of this half, they've had some good offense going, but they really got caught out. They had committed too much up the field, and they weren't able to really they had too much committed to one side of the field and left the right side of the field widely open, which is why Goodwin was able to pull up there.
Absolutely. Really unfortunate deflection as it went right into the open part of the net.
Aside from that, Morton, he's been really good in goal today. 6 saves. He's been really a solid force there, but unfortunately there's not much. There's only so much one person can do there.
You can see the frustrated Blue Hens trying to make an attack with the Legato. Coming up field, passes it off to the outside, number 7. And we'll shot, and we'll go off the post. Shot by Carlos Perales. Missed it by a hair.
Real great attack. You see there was a slight deflection there by Melvin in the goal. Just pushed it into the post and ended up hitting him in the back. I'm sure he was relieved when he felt that ball roll into his back, just knowing that, hey, I didn't give up that goal.
Absolutely. And this crowd is riled up with this tie match.
Not a surprising score. 1-1. These two teams were talking about it at the start of the game. It really going to be neck and neck, really fighting for this position. Two great teams, and they're really showing it right now.
Morgan headed that out. It will be Blue Hen ball. Blue Hens looking for the attack. Looked like he was going to rip the shot. Some contact. Fans not liking that one here. Bonner passes on the outside to number 11, Ben Fisher. Fisher with the cross to the far side. Good header.
UNCW's attack, 7 shots on goal for this game. They've really been making Morton work out there. Not really giving them much of a break. They've always been knocking on the door.
Looks like the Seahawks are looking to make a substitution in the near future. That is Seahawks throwing. The cross. Headed up by the Blue Hens. Fisher rips a shot and will go up high. Morton didn't have to worry about that one as it was around 30 feet above the crossbar.
Still, that was a good build-up by UNCW. Just couldn't quite close it out.
Looks like they're getting a little bit more momentum in this half.
Mm-hmm.
They were completely washed out for the first 10 minutes of this one.
Oh, absolutely. Delaware was forcing it in their side in their half for good portion of the start of this half. They were just up there, constantly creating pressure, making the defense fall back there. And now it just seems like it's completely flip-flopped. Seems like Delaware is now on their back foot.
Delgado loses it. Back in Blue in possession. As will be kicked all the way back to the goalkeeper, Melvin. Melvin to Meekum. Meekum to Bylander. Cordero slips on that one. Might be costly. BC Hawks throwing after it hit Frost. Go,
Looks like that substitution is going to be made. That is number 7, Shane Meekum, coming into the game.
Bonner trying to create some opportunity here. Crosses it to the far side. Blue Hens all over that one. And right back at the Seahawk possession. Fisher with the cross. And the referees will call offsides on that one.
Delaware looks to be playing with 3 midfielders, playing in more of a defensive role. Seem to definitely be trying to, I guess, right now they're probably, like I said earlier, on their back foot. They're trying to slow down this UNCW attack, which has been relentless in the past 10 so minutes.
Pass it upfield. Goalkeeper will cut that one off.
Morton didn't want any of that one. He just wanted to pick that up and just shut it down right away.
Garcia with the header.
Clever little back heel pass, unfortunately slips out for Delaware, and ball's going to go to UNCW.
Attack being made on the Blue Hen side. Last touch by the Seahawks, as it will be a goal kick. Be sure to follow men's soccer at Delaware MSOC to follow all their behind-the-scenes work all season long.
Approaching right now the 20-minute mark for the second half. All tied up, 1-1.
And once again, you're tuned in to Hens All Access broadcast of Delaware men's soccer. Stephen O'Charlie here with Mike Hutz. Great to have you all tuned in with us.
Looks like Guillermo might have hit his head just a little bit. Player down for UNCW. Calling on the training staff.
A lot of contact here in this match so far.
Oh, yeah, we talked about it earlier. They've been getting physical. They're really fighting. It's a battle for the ball. You got 2 players running up to the sideline. You get a lot of pushing, a lot of shoving, just trying to win possession there. Here there's an update. Old Dominion scored 1 goal over at field hockey at Rulo. 2-1 right now. Delaware still leading. Number 3, Michael Meekum, is being taken off the field right now. The trainer's going to just go over and look at him. Walking off on him by himself. And a drop ball. Guillermo just kicks it over towards Melvin.
And we are back on our way here. B- by Lander to Garcia. Garcia will dish it off. Trying to move upfield is Bonner. Large presence. And he's moving up. We'll cross it in and we'll be cut off by the Blue Hens. Blue Hens trying to be on the attack. Delgado on the outside trying to save that one, keep that one in. Morgan had different plans.
Yeah, UNCW, their attack is really, they've been playing the long ball well. You get a long cross from just over midfield, and it tends to drop right into a UNC player. They seem to just know where to go and be on the end of it.
Bonner with some contact. Trying to possibly get the call. Jose Garcia with the free kick.
That looks like Michael Meekum is back on the field. Glad to see him back out here.
Headed by Thibaut Philippe. Matt Morgan will pass it back to Meekum. Meekum will cross field to Bylander. Bylander to Cordero, who Cordero passes it back to Meekum. Shane Meekum, that is, and a great save by the redshirt freshman, Todd Morton.
Really, really having a good game right now. Aside from that one goal, he's had good hands. He hasn't let the ball bobble around at all. When he grabs it, he holds it. He just had that one unfortunate shot deflection that just bounced in just the right way for UNCW to score.
It's a great presence to have in front of the net, especially as a redshirt freshman. He's been here for a year. He's seen what's happened.
Oh, yeah.
Didn't get too much playing time as he is a redshirt freshman, but it is really good to see such a young guy be so comfortable in such a big position.
Oh, yeah. He's definitely settled. Really, obviously, he's had the season right now to play, but to come in here and have a season like he's had as a freshman, it's impressive. And it's good to know that we're going to see him in net for a few more years.
Seahawks trying to create some opportunity here with the Blue Hens, having none of that. Blue Hens trying to regain control here as we are all tied up with about 15 minutes left to go. Blue Hens 1, Seahawks 1. Blue Hens with 8 shots and Seahawks with 10. Matt Morgan with the header. Delgado trying to find something. Gillen to the outside. Pass in. A little bit of contact. Gillen. Pass in to Gillen. Delgado right there waiting for it. Some great footwork on the outside. The cross in, and there's no one there to put it in the back of the net.
Looks like Delaware might not be quite finished yet with his attack. They're still pressuring.
And the clear out.
UNCW decided otherwise. There should be a lot more midfield play for Delaware in this half. There's a lot of passing, trying to create opportunities now. It's looks almost completely different than the first 10 minutes of this half. They were really going full force then. Now they're trying to take a more calculated approach towards it.
Gillen passes it outside to Frost. Back to Gillen. Seahawks trying to cut all that off. Perales with the ball. Frost will dish it out. Looking upfield.
Ooh, good touch. Good touch.
Looking for the shot. He will move it back. Take the shot. It'll be saved by Sean Melvin, the goalkeeper for the Seahawks.
That was some real good footwork. Just weaving his way around a few players, getting them up close. Melvin just able to focus enough, though. Keep it out.
That was Severio with that pressure. Very calm approach when he went in there. Did not rush his shot.
Not at all. He definitely went in there. He had a plan in his mind. He executed that plan. Was able to get through. The shot was just not quite.
Goalkeeper was at the right place at the right time.
Yeah, exactly.
Morton looking to kick it off.
That's going to be Matt John Fratone in for Ben Fisher.
Once again, we would like to thank you for joining our broadcast here at Hens All Access. Stephen Ocho alongside Mike Hutz. This broadcast is brought to you by St. Francis Healthcare. Delgado trying to add some pressure to Morgan's defense. Pressure's on for the Blue Hens. Frost the ball. Passes right back. A little off target, and the Seahawks will regain possession. Cromer with the ball. Passes it off. Looking for Bonner. Bonner moving in. Just misses that touch. We'll cross it in, and we'll be off the Blue Hens. Might want to be careful with the kick like that.
Yeah. But again, you can see the physicality of this game. Real everything getting in close. Oh.
As that will go right off the top of the netting, as it did not look to be as close as that really was.
Oh, no. There was a few fans. I can see them from here. They stood up, and they were ready to start cheering, and then just kind of saw it roll down the back of the net. I was tricked for a second there. I thought that might have gone in.
Absolutely. It looked like, from my perspective, it looked like that was going to be far side, way too high, but that really did dip down and go up on the top of the netting.
Sure made a few people's heart jump just a little bit. Ian Hennessy getting his own touch over there of the ball. Looks like he wants to come into the game.
Blue Hens will need any added offense at this point.
Dangerous challenge there. Ref's going to let it go.
All ball, says the ref.
Frost with the ball on the near side. That is number 20.
Almost identical right there. Delaware running up into UNCW side. Ball stolen. Same thing happens right away after as UNCW moves into the Delaware side.
Little miscue of a kick to give it right back in the hands of the Seahawks. Looking for a shot here. He's moving into the box. Keeps on moving. Goalkeeper comes in and will snag that one.
Martin again stopping an attack before the shot's even off.
Not feared to come into high-pressure situation right there.
He's been playing fairly aggressive today when people are coming into the box. He's telling them, this is my territory. You better stay out. Coming in there, grabbing it, picking it right up from their foot.
Just about 7 minutes left in this game. Both teams tied up 1-1. As we are at a stalemate here in Newark, Delaware at Stort and Suzanne Grant Stadium. Thibaut Philippe passes it back to Frost. Right back to Philippe. We'll get it to Frost. Taken away by Cordero of the Seahawks. Right back into Blue Hens. Possession. Lee left out. Blue Hens looking to set something up right here on the attack side. Frost to Perales. Carlos passes it upfield. In the corner are the Blue Hens. Seahawks trying to hold them to a throw-in as it's crossed in and headed out, cleared by the Seahawks. Bonner looking to get on the offense here. Getting upfield, large presence as he's going in. Looks to take the shot and it's deflected and it is saved.
That was a great kick by Morton, just sticking his leg out there, catching the ball and just pushing it wide.
The redshirt freshman throws that leg out, makes the save. How big of a save is that?
Oh, that was huge. Bonner, amazing scorer, having an amazing season, getting almost a one-on-one situation with the goalie. To have that kind of presence and take that attack like that and be able to save, that's huge for the game. That's possible. That could have possibly just saved him the game.
Delaware defense is not done here. They need to. This is a very, very kick right here, very, very big corner kick right here. Garcia with the kick. It's up. The cross hits the crossbar.
Oh, man, this UNCW attack is unrelenting. Still coming in, still pushing strong. Luckily there, a little help from the crossbar on that header, keeping it at a level game 1-1.
Missed it by Seahawk Feather. Morton with the kick. As it will go right along midfield to kick forward by number 10, Marco Cervello. The header by Frost to Cervello. Samson will pass it back. Looking for it on the far sideline as it will be Seahawks ball. Wind starting to pick up here at Stort and Suzanne Grant Stadium. As we have almost about 3 minutes left in today's contest, with things all being knotted up at one. Bonner looking for a little chip, and the line ref has his flag up. Samson with the kick up.
Just keeping that in, letting his teammate come up, pick up the ball, keep the attack going.
And here is number 7, Carlos Perales here, and we'll just get it above the crossbar. Very close. Blue Hen fans were on their feet for that one. About 2 minutes and 10 seconds left in this one. Ball will cross midfield, head into Blue Hen territory as we headed back into the box. It'll be a throw in for the Seahawks. Cordero with the ball, crosses it in, kicked out by the Blue Hens. Once again cleared.
Again, like I said earlier, this UNCW attack, it's really been there. When it gets in there, they come 3-4 times.
And here's the attack for the Blue Hens with under a minute and 30 seconds remaining. Throw in, and it looks like a Seahawk is down. Slow to get up. A minute and 23 seconds remaining.
Now, if this game goes into overtime, this will be second year in a row. Last game won 1-0 by Delaware. Overtime goal scored by Guillermo. Maybe we'll end up with something similar.
Absolutely.
Maybe he can add another goal to his total. Get one within one goal. He's about to be tied for second for most goals in the school history.
And no one in Stort and Suzanne Grant Stadium is going anywhere for this one. Blue Hens looking to get that ball back as the Seahawks will make an attack.
And there it is. Good defensive stop there. Read the ball path, just got in front of it.
Blue Hens at the ball. Frost on the near sideline.
Again, you're seeing that kind of passing it around, trying to spread the defense of UNCW around. Looking like it might have worked just there.
On the far side with the cross in. Goalkeeper Melvin had that one.
That was a long shot. That was a good one. That definitely threatened a little bit.
Keeping Melvin on his toes. Under 30 seconds remaining in the second half.
Delaware probably has about one more chance to get something done. Otherwise, we'll be seeing you guys in overtime.
Under 10 seconds remaining in the second half of this competition here in Newark, Delaware. Once again, Hens All Access all over this coverage. As that will wrap up the second half. With Delaware Blue Hens with 1 and UNC Wilmington 1. There will be overtime coming. Huts, let's talk about the second half right now. Delaware came out very, very strong. What did you see differently between the first and second half?
Definitely at the start of it, they came out with more confidence. I think what really happened was that goal by UNCW, kind of took some of that confidence away. They really came out swinging. They were ready to attack. They were ready to go strong. Unfortunately, there was that one counterattack. They just committed a little too much, and UNCW was able to pull back on the side of the field, get that shot in, and the unfortunate deflection off Morton gave them that opportunity to tee up for a goal.
Absolutely. Morton with 10 saves. What was different about that shot that did find the back of the net for Morton?
The shot that found the back of the net there, it came in on an angle. It was really powerful, and that's one of the most difficult jobs for a goalie is when you get a shot coming at you that hard, you're supposed to tuck that ball and you're supposed to hold it. But if a shot's coming at you as hard as it was, a lot of times it's really hard to get that, and it came in on an angle that it bounced into a position you could see right on the right side of the box. It was just when he was already on the ground, there really wasn't anything he could have done. But that one save he did have on Bonner, that's something special to have a goalie running out there in a one-on-one situation, attacking the ball and thinking to kick his leg out in case that he tries to shoot wide, and he guessed right and was able to keep the score 1-1, and that's why we're going into overtime now.
Absolutely. Now, we discussed the keys of the game brought to you by Chevy. Do you think those did translate over into the second half at all?
I think they definitely did. I don't think Delaware, they started, their transition became a little bit sloppier. I think it was because when UNCW scored that goal, I think, it took a bit of the confidence out of there.
Mm-hmm.
I think it kind of, threw them off a little bit and made them try to play safer. So even when they're attacking, they need to constantly be thinking, all right, what happens if we don't score here? Aside from that, they've really been following it. Obviously, you could see that threat from Bonner there. That's why you got to lock in on him. But the defensive focus still been good. Delaware still looking all right, and I guess we'll see what happens when it goes into overtime.
Absolutely. This Hens All Access coverage is being brought to you by your local Chevy dealer. Visit ChevyDealer.com to find a dealer near you. We're actually going to go to a short break, and we'll catch you right back up as soon as the overtime begins here at Stuart and Suzanne Grant Stadium in Newark, Delaware. Steve Nojoey here with Mike Hutz. We'll be right back after this small commercial break.
Stay connected with the Blue Hens on all social media outlets. Follow at UD Blue Hens on Twitter for score updates, news, and everything Delaware sports. Check out at Hens All Access to see what it takes behind the scenes to bring you Delaware athletics. Interact with the University of Delaware Fightin' Blue Hens on Facebook to get to know the athletes and hear about events offered to Blue Hens fans. And take a look at UD Blue Hens on Instagram for game times, game finals, along with throwbacks of old Hens and promos for future Hens.
I'm on a hill, King Kendrick, resurrecting my vengeance. Been dissecting your motor mouth till I break down the engine. This ain't a one shot, this a relevant henchman. See my opponent, then cease your existence. See, it's gonna take a whole lot of y'all to kill me. I never die, my pedigree apparently only to idolize. Ahead of me is only my future and idle time. Longevity, I gotta get used to making you mine. You telling me I only get used to living is fine. You can never live in my shoes, permanently pit from God.
When the sun goes down, I scream loud, sleep when I die.
Company, so I need to collect your phone so you can't post pictures. Okay, how does it feel to not be connected?
My chest hurts.
Well, let me give your phones back. Let me show you a better way to keep connected. The 2016 Chevy Cruze offers built-in 4G LTE Wi-Fi that connects up to 7 devices.
So this thing puts out its own signal?
Yes.
This is next level, Chevy.
Globetrotters!
This is where you won't believe becomes you'll never forget.
Returning to the Bob Carpenter Center, March 8th at 7. For tickets, log on to Ticketmaster.com.
And welcome back to Hens All Access coverage of CAA soccer. Here we have the UNC Wilmington Seahawks against the home team of the University of Delaware Blue Hens. And in baseball, we call it free baseball, but here at soccer, I guess we can call it some free soccer as we head into overtime here at Stuart and Suzanne Grant Stadium. Steven Ochoa alongside Mike Hutz. Are we ready for this one?
Oh, yeah, we're ready. I think we were ready from the start. We knew this was going to be a big game, and here we are, overtime, 1-1. This game, I'll put it this way, it's very fitting. The game has huge implications for the postseason. Two spots in the standing right now up for grabs, essentially. I'd say it's pretty fitting that this is going into overtime, really, really working this game.
And as we discussed before, this game, with a win for the Blue Hens, would have their chance of playing at home in the CAA tournament more likely. With a loss, that likeliness diminishes.
Yeah, and definitely if they end up against UNCW, that 8-game unbeaten home streak that unfortunately for them was recently snapped, that could definitely play into it. They definitely seem like more of a home team than a road team. So Delaware really looking to bring it back here and just play on home field here at Stewart and Suzanne Grant Stadium and just kind of, I guess, feel more comfortable about it.
And it was like night and day for the Blue Hens between the first and second half.
Yeah.
Blue Hens were very much on defense pretty much the majority of the second half. And then come the second half for the first half. And then come the second half, it was like a completely new, different team.
Absolutely. They really came out swinging. They were really ready for what was going to be thrown at them. And unfortunately, it ended up not turning out their way. But here we are now.
Absolutely. And the Hawks were just snapped of some offensive pressure right there. Blue Hens think there's some contact. Not sure how likely that was. As it will be Blue Hen throwing.
You can look at the field right now and you can see the kind of pressure UNCW has. They have one player on the defensive side of the field right now. They're really fighting, really making sure they can do it.
As Delgado passes it back across midfield. Perales to Frost. Philippe across midfield. Matt Morgan with the ball. Passes it to Jose Garcia. The middle of the field. Bonner passes to Garcia, who passes it upfield into the box. Looks to be offside, says the line ref. That will be right back in the hands of Todd Morton.
You definitely see Delaware's defense was playing more aggressive. They really attacking the ball. You could see the UNCW player was probably about a third of the way up the field, and they were chasing him. So it definitely seems like they're taking a different approach to their defense now.
That pass looking for Bonner right there. Bonner moving upfield, trying to create some chances for the Seahawks.
Good work to get that one out.
Blue Hens moving up, trying to create some offensive pressure as he moves up field. Delgado trying to snag that one. A chip into the box. Headed out, right back to Delgado. Delgado to the far side. Pushing to the far corner. Surrounded by Seahawks as he will fall to the ground, and it will be a goal kick for number one, Sean Melvin.
It's a little bit of contact on that run. Heard some of the fans yelling, not happy about it, but that's the kind of offensive pressure that the Delaware really needs to keep up. They need to have those quick, fast runs that help put them ahead in the first.
Here's a Delaware throw-in, Frost, and it will go right back into the hands of the Seahawks with Cordero with the throw-in. Calvin Cromer with the ball. To Jordan Cordero, back to Cordero. Cromer. Pass to the far side of the field.
Seahawks with the ball. As they're looking to add some pressure into the Blue Hens defense. A beautiful fall day, 66 degrees. It did rain last night, so the field is a little damp. A little bit windy as well, but cannot put a dim on how great of a contest this is we have here in Newark, Delaware today. Delaware looking to add some pressure on the attack of the Seahawks. Pass to Delgado, and the shot, and he loses it. Seahawks get it right back.
See, the good thing about that is you can see that they're, Delaware really is creating these chances. They're really getting in there. But they're, unfortunately, UNCW really locked in. It seems like they've really locked into Delgado for this game. And whenever he gets the ball, there's usually at least two defenders who have him marked. So he's really having trouble to get make things happen.
And that will go right into possession of Sean Melvin.
Again, seeing some of that contact right there. Real physical game.
Though we're looking to create some opportunity down on the far side. Cordero looking to shut things down. As that will sneak in and be a throw-in.
Just barely. That was a good defensive effort there. Good thought to try to kick it that way, but you could hear that little exhale there by the crowd there when you saw that roll for a throw-in. Everyone just kind of all at the same time just disappointed.
Frost snowing with the throw-in. As the Seahawks will clear it.
Looks like that's a Delaware throw-in. See if they can't make something happen here.
Delaware players looking to show the referees some contact on the Seahawks side. That will be cleared out by the Seahawks. And will be a Seahawk throw-in. Throwing the ball in for the Seahawks was number 11, Ben Fisher. Cordero with the ball. As we are ending this first overtime here in Newark, Delaware, what did you see different between the second half and this first overtime here?
Well, in this, it looked they did have, I think, a couple more, I guess, I'd say creative attacks with the one with Delgado really getting into the box up close. They look strong on the attack and on defense, but both sides seem to definitely be a bit slower than they were. I don't know, maybe that's a fatigue, maybe that's because both teams are trying to be more cautious here, not to give up that first goal. They both seem to be, I guess, have slowed down a little bit is what I'm trying to say. I think definitely UNCW is looking a bit more, I guess, attentive to details when they're passing and getting in close, and they've gotten in a few times. They've gotten close, but Delaware's defense really locking down, really holding down the fort right now, keeping them in for the second overtime.
Absolutely. It's great to see Todd Morton really have a great presence throughout that half, throughout that overtime as well. We will get back to more soccer here at Stuart and Suzanne Grant Stadium, but we'll send you off to a short break and have you right back with the second overtime here in New York, Delaware.
Stay connected with the Blue Hens on all social media outlets. Follow at UD Blue Hens on Twitter for score updates, news, and everything Delaware sports. Check out at Hens All Access to see what it takes behind the scenes to bring you Delaware athletics. Interact with the University of Delaware Fightin' Blue Hens on Facebook to get to know the athletes and hear about events offered to Blue Hens fans. And take a look at UD Blue Hens on Instagram for game times, game finals, along with throwbacks of old Hens and promos for future Hens.
I tell them on a hill, King Kendrick, resurrecting my vengeance, been dissecting your motor mouth till I break down the engine. This ain't a wanna shot, this a relevant henchman. See my opponent, then cease your existence. See, it's gonna take a whole lot of y'all to kill me. I never die, my pedigree apparently only to idolize. Ahead of me, it's only my future and idle time. Longevity, I gotta get used to making you mine. You telling me I only get used to living is fine. You can never live in my shoes, probably leaping from God.
When the sun goes down, I scream loud, sleep when I die.
Marketing research company, so I need to collect your phone so you can't post pictures. Okay, how does it feel to not be connected?
My chest hurts.
Well, let me give your phones back. Let me show you a better way to keep connected. The 2016 Chevy Cruze offers built-in 4G LTE Wi-Fi that connects up to 7 devices.
So this thing puts out its own signal?
Yes.
This is next level, Chevy.
Globetrotters!
This is where you won't believe becomes you'll never forget.
Returning to the Bob Carpenter Center March 8th at 7. For tickets, log on to Ticketmaster.com.
And welcome back to Hens All Access's broadcast of CAA Soccer here in Newark, Delaware at Stuart and Suzanne Grant Stadium, home of the Delaware Blue Hens, where we are going into our second overtime. And it is just taken off with a kick by Garcia to the far side.
This is probably the most important 10 minutes of the game right now, deciding possibly where people will end at the end of the season. Standings at stake, third spot. Like we said earlier at the start of the game, if Delaware wins this, they will hop UNCW and take the third spot in the CAA standings, at least for now.
There's fans looking for a card on that one.
And they get it. That's going to be a yellow card.
That card will be issued to Michael Meekum, the senior defender out of Blackbird, Virginia.
Just getting word here from over at Rulo Stadium. Delaware Field Hockey beat Old Dominion 2-1. Really, really looking strong going into the postseason. Excited to see what they can do.
Absolutely. Definitely a completely different game than the last one. The last one was a 9-0 win over the Towson Tigers at home at Rulo. As we're looking at a Blue Hen throw-in on the far side.
Definitely more presence on the UNCW side of the field for the Blue Hens already, playing most of this half down there.
And we will have a corner kick on the far right side. Fans are on their toes here at Grant Stadium. Not many have left the facility. They have all remained in their seats.
Not much of a reason to leave this. It's a nice day out, sun's shining, good game of soccer going on.
Crossed in, headed out.
Delaware not done with it yet.
Shot deflected, cleared out. Blue one's trying to head it right back in, create more offensive opportunities.
Delgado. Excuse me, not Delgado. That was number 10, Marco Severio. having some good moves up there, keeping the ball up there, a little bit of a spin. Just kind of keeping the pressure on the UNCW side of the field.
Delgado's pass was cut off. Gillen with the pass. That will find its way into the seats. Number 24, Ryan Nally with the throw-in, which will be booted away by number 4, Joel Vinelander. And kicked right back into Seahawk territory. Vinelander passes it to number 24, Nally. Back to midfield. Could have been a dangerous cutoff by the Blue Hens right there. Cordero with the ball. It will be last touched off the Blue Hens.
About 7 minutes remaining in the second half of overtime. Really important game right here. Both teams, a lot at stake. Definitely can expect to see them turn on the burners here.
Blue Hens with 10 shots on the day and Seahawks with 12 shots on the day. Pass up to Vinelander. Oh, we'll sneak it to Nally. Get it upfield. Will be cut off by the Blue Hens. Gillen will kick it out and will remain Seahawks ball.
Ball's been mostly on the side of the Seahawks now getting into the Delaware side, but Delaware's really been controlling it well.
Just under 6 minutes remaining in the second overtime. It will remain with the Blue Hens as number 3, Talbot will be throwing it back in. Move it across, trying to create some opportunities here.
Some of the implications of this game with a win here. Delaware will have sole possession of third place with wins against JMU and William & Mary, ending the season with games against JMU and William & Mary, both below us in the standings right now, so looking to possibly be a way for Delaware to lock in that third spot. With a tie, we will be tied with Charleston, but we hold the tiebreaker, so we for fourth place with both games against JMU and William & Mary, again, below us in the standings, so possible opportunities for Delaware to climb in the standings before that CAA tournament creeps up on us.
As we will have a new Seahawk coming into the game. Calvin Cromer coming into the game. Once again, we'd like to thank you for tuning in to Hens All Access broadcast of today's CAA matchup. It is being brought to you by St. Francis Healthcare.
And again, with those two situations that I just brought up to you, in both of those situations, third or fourth place, we will host the quarterfinal game here at Stuart and Suzanne Grant Stadium on Delaware turf. Looks to be Delaware corner coming up. Another chance for them to possibly let that ball find the back of the net.
Fans here are restless, looking for this corner kick. Far right side. This kick is crossed in. It's a good cross. And headed in and hit the side of the net.
Close one. Good placement of that corner, though.
That one was headed in
by Ben Sampson, the senior midfielder from Woodbury, Minnesota.
Another one of the example of Delaware knocking at the door. They've really been doing that for most of this second overtime here. Really, really fighting, really want it. You can hear the fans out there shaking the bleachers, getting loud. Only about 2.5 minutes left in the second overtime, seeing if either team can make something happen here.
Morgan with it. We'll pass it upfield. Be cut off by the Blue Hens. That one was intended by Goodwin. Cordero with the throw in. A good one at that. Will be cleared. Delgado racing it down. Will be cleared by the goalkeeper, Sean Melvin.
Delaware again with a throw in the UNCW side of the field. Once again, that pressure they're really putting on here. They're really not really giving much of a break right now. Minute and a half remaining in the second overtime. Some good play in here there.
Matt Morgan with the ball. We'll pass it right off to Sean Melvin. Just under a minute here remaining in the second overtime here at Stort and Suzanne Grant Stadium. Garcia will kick it back. Right back to the hands of the Blue Hens. This time is winding down here in the second overtime with things all knotted up at one. Under 30 seconds remaining here.
It's looking like this might be the last chance in the game right now to possibly get a game winner.
Matt Morgan will try to clear that one out. As this looks like it will be the last attack available for the Blue Hens. There is now less than 10 seconds remaining in this overtime. The cross in, the header will be cleared, will stay in the territory, and will go right into the hands of Melvin as time will wind out. As this one will end, all knotted up at one for the Blue Hens and the Seahawks. Once again, you were tuned into Hens All Access, broadcast of CAA Soccer. What did you think of that second overtime now?
Delaware definitely came out swinging. They definitely wanted that win, but UNCW, their defense really locked them down. And again, that tie, makes us tied in the CAA standings at Charleston, but we take fourth place due to tiebreaker. Again, we will be hosting a quarterfinal game for the CAA tournament here because of that result. Obviously, would have preferred a win over UNCW. Close game, good teams up in the standings, but again, great game fought by both teams.
Absolutely.
Both came out swinging.
Now, we will be hosting that game if we do win the next two games coming up.
Yes.
Very big games. One of them is at home here on Wednesday at 7 o'clock versus JMU. Very big game. We would love to all have you tuned in with here at Hens All Access.
That would be the final home game of the season, of the regular season, that is.
Perfect. And once again, from all of us here at Hens All Access, Stephen Ochoa and Mike Hutz, here live from Stort and Suzanne Grant Stadium. It's been a great progress, and we would like to thank you all for tuning in. Have a great night.